goods, local Goans who have rented out their houses to foreigners, and the struggles and aspirations of people of Goa, people who come down from various parts of the country to Goa in search of livelihood during the peak season, and the people who come from abroad as tourists to spend some quality time for the coming 6 months. So the film is primarily about what happens during this 6 months, Baga Beach, a season in paradise.
So Lakshmikantji has basically given the, you can say, the basic idea behind the film, and which I have also come to know from him, is that the film is basically about the conflict of interest of the tourists, the people who come from outside, and the people living on the beach, not only on Baga Beach, but in the whole state of Goa. So basically it's a problem dealing with the people living on and off the beach. So Dr. Salgaonkar, would you like to just throw light on other aspects of the film?
Actually, the film Baga Beach is really not about a place just in Goa. This kind of struggle, this kind of life is led by people in any tourist destination, particularly on the beach. So when I heard the script and director, when he narrated the script to me, for me it was an opportunity. Because I have worked with women and children, and I have worked with particularly the marginalized sections of people. And for me, it was an opportunity to showcase the kind of life, kind of struggle, how these people really survive in an atmosphere which is sometimes very hostile and sometimes absolutely, what they were looking for. Like, for example, the role of Shobha, which Pauli has done. This role, the girl, this beautiful young girl, a bead seller on the beach, I actually have seen so many like that, and how they live their life, that they come here with aspirations to lead a good life, to make money. Goa for them, for the people from nearby states, is like a place where there is a lot of money, and they only need the grit and the determination to take it. So this girl with dreams in her eyes, she comes, she does the business, but at the same time she finds a foreigner, she falls in love with him. There is another, it's a love triangle. There's a boy whose role Akash has done, and he's a real struggler. He comes from the lower strata of society, but when he comes to Goa, actually he's not come now, he's come many years back. His parents are here. We see so many such cases. Parents have lived here, the children are even born here, they are brought up in Goa. But in Goa, as a Goan, I can say, we always consider them as outsiders. Just the way our Goans, when they go to other lands, to Gulf or other places, they are an outsider. Likewise, these young people who are grown in Goa with us, we never consider them as Goans. And look at the struggle, look at the kind of life that they lead in Goa. It's mind-blowing. They really struggle to survive. And not that, it's just a short period, just one season. And sometimes we wonder, what do they do when there are no tourists? Now, Akash, when we thought about him to cast him in this role, we were in two minds, I remember. That because we wanted, and director always, she was looking for people with dark skin, people who looked like South Indians, people who wanted to, who are really, we have to feel that they really lived life on the beach. So I was doubtful about Akash, but the way he has come out in this film and throughout the shooting, it was wonderful. Both my lead actor and actors have done a great job. Now as for director, he's a national awardee, so this was expected of him, that he will do a good job. And I'm happy that I'm able to, and my son has supported me throughout, Dr. Sagar, that the life which I have seen in hospitals, the crowd that comes from the beach, as patients, they come as in Women's Commission. I saw these struggling women, these children, and then I realized this was an opportunity. Let the world know. I mean, there is a, such a vibrant and beautiful, colorful